Now, as we said, we have in this chapter, in this course, fluid mechanics, we are talking about all the fluids that we have. I want just to add here. Now, we clarify that what we have in this course and what should we take this course about. And the main idea or the main point that we are dealing with in this course is the basic information of the statics and kinematic and dynamic of the fluid. So as you all know that every glass of water, that hold water, it's about 250 mL. That's the volume, is that right? So volume is the one of the properties of this liquid or if of this fluid. And if we went and if we want to take how much it will weigh, so we will have to make to put it in a balance, so then we will have its weight. Now we have the weight and the volume. So if I divided the weight by volume, it will give me a parameter is called the specific weight or specific density and so on. So these are all called the basic properties of the physical properties of water, of the liquids, of the fluids in general. Here's the resources that we have. Basically I am preferring this one. White fluid mechanics, and there are many books that are it can be used for the our course, but I'm preferring that first of all go with the lecture notes and go with the slides. Then if you have any difficulties or if you want to solve more questions, you can go to the books. Excuse me, just I wanted to make sure. Just a minute. Again, I'm sorry for that break. Now, in this course, we are talking about the properties of the fluid in general and the static of the fluids. What is the static of the fluid? If you have a swimming pool, like, let me say, like a pool, swimming pool like this, and so, to design this swimming pool, let me say that if I wanted to know how much is the load that's coming above the roof of this swimming pool, then I should know how much is the load that's coming from that liquid. And the liquid or the fluid is now in a static status or in a static in arrest. So how much is a load is coming from a liquid when it's in the rest? It's called static. So static loads or static pressure that we have, it comes from the liquid that is in a rest position. While we have in dynamics, when we have a dam. This is a dam, and the dam, there is a wave that's coming and hitting the wall of the dam, and it's moving. So whenever you have, or a wind, let me say, but if we have a river, and the river is hitting a wall or a gate, now these are the loads that's coming from the fluids when the fluids are in or the liquid is in an in motion state, then it's called dynamic status or dynamic fluid, and we have to measure its the impact on the structures. And now we have to know how much is the flow of the fluid, how many meter cube that we will have due to the motion of the fluid through a channel of a pipe. These are called measurements of the fluid. And how can I measure the flow? Let me say if I have a river, let me say this is a river, and this river, this is the cross-sectional area of this river, and here's the level of water in this channel, and it's going this way. So here's the natural ground level. So if somebody asks you to know how much is the cube, how much is the flow from this cross section area, so you have to know that we have device at, we have devices that used for measuring the flow. We have weirs. We have small wheels, we have venturi, we have many other devices that we know that we need to know the flow of this liquid in this fluid. Dimensional analysis. I state that dimensional analysis. So when I say that I have velocity of a river, of a liquid, let me say this is a pipe, and this pipe have a cross-sectional or have a diameter of D. So, and we have a water or a liquid that's passing through this pipe. So D, if it was, it's the diameter of the pipe. So it will be measured either in millimeter or centimeter or in meter, so or in foot or something else. So here we have in dimensional analysis, we are not using units, we are using like letters for, so they will use a D as L, L for length. So whether we have millimeters or centimeters or feet or anything else that millimeter, these are only measurements of the dimension. So when I say that D will be in length units or length measurement units, so we will substitute that D with L. And if I want to know area, so area is equal for any pipe is equal to pi D squared over 4. Is that right? Is that true?
Yes.
Yes. So pi, and I will substitute instead of D, diameter of the pipe, I will substitute L. So I will use L squared over 4. So this unit, and there is another unit here, so I can say what is the volume. The volume here, so L squared is a dimensional analysis of the area. So can you tell me what is the dimensional analysis of the volume? It's basically equal to area and times a length. For example, if I have a cylinder, here's a cylinder. So the volume of this cylinder is equal to area of the base times the height. Now, the area is measured in L square, and the height is measured in length or L. So the volume can be represented by L cube, okay? Now, if I want to know how much Q is there in this pipe, you will say Q is equal to volume divided by time. Is that right? Volume, how much meter cube that I have that passing a certain point from, let's say this is a point, how much meter cube of a liquid that's passing through this point in a specific time, let me say for 1 second. So here's the Q. So Q is equal to volume divided by T. Then in dimensional analysis, they used for volume L cubed. This is volume. For area, they use it L squared. That's for meter squared, feet squared, and so on. For time, they use it T. T is representing second, minute, hour, day, week, year, everything that's measuring to the unit time. So in this way, if I want to know the units of flow or Q, I will just say Q is equal to volume divided by time, which is equal to L cubed divided by T. This technique in measurements, in analyzing measures, or analyzing the units, it's called dimensional analysis. So we will take this one, dimensional analysis, for our course. Also, we have dynamics of viscous fluid flow in closed pipes, and we have open pipes or open channels. So we will go furthermore to know how much is the flow in a pipe. And for a pipe, we have, when I'm talking on a, for a pipe, so I'm talking for a fully, we have a fully flow pipe, but this is called closed pipe. Closed pipe, definitely all the pipes are closed, but in fluids, when I'm talking for a flow, closed pipe, I mean the liquid is passing through whole diameter, it's covering. The whole pipe is used by the fluid. But while we have open flow channel, if the flow through, if the same pipe will use to pack, to transfer a liquid or a fluid, with not a fully, with a partially flow, this cannot be called a closed pipe. This is can be called an open channel, an open pipe, an open conduit, and so on. So here's the points that I measured and what we will study on it. So in statistics or in statics, we will measure the pressure. The pressure of a liquid that's in rest on a specific body. Like for example, we have, as I said, we have a swimming pool. Like I have a tank, or let me say we have a body under the, this is a body or a cube that's lie beneath the water. For example, we have 2 meter water on this, above this surface of this box. So what I want to know is whether, how much is the pressure that is exerted due to that head of water. For example, if I have a tank, this is a tank filled with water, okay? And there is a tab of water, or there is a tab that's used to drain the water. So how much is the pressure that will be exerted on the tab? Because we wanna, if there is no pipe, there is no level of water, then there is no liquids drained from this tab, then there is zero pressure. As much as you have more level of water, then it will be more pressure on this one. And I will in the next lectures, if there is a surface of water here and the pressure of water on this side, and if this is a concrete, let me say a wall, so we are putting, let me say, if I have 3 meters of a concrete wall here and it's 3 meters, it means the depth of water here. So in this point at the top of the point, because the liquid is free surface, there is no any pressure on this one. While at this point we have 3 meter pressure, 3 meters of water pressure on that, this one. So this point, point A, is holding a weight of liquids that's exerted through to 3 meters of water. And that can be said, it's equal to gamma H. Gamma H, or gamma is the pressure at any point. Here, I am, if the datum is here, datum, if the datum is here and I want to measure the pressure at here, so the pressure of water, so I have to, from this one, the pressure at this point due to the 3 meters water is equal to gamma H. How much is the gamma of water? Gamma of water is equal to 1,000 kilograms per 1 meter cube, is that right? That times the H. H is the distance of the water above that point. So if I am, if there is nothing here, there is no load on my head. No, but if there is 2 meters water, so there are 2 meters times 1,000 kilogram of water head load on my head. So at the same point. Now, so if there is 3 meters, so 3 times 300, so it will become 3,000 kilogram per meter. By the way, per meter square. Why per meter square? Because we have three dimension of this three is in meter, and we have meter cube, so it will be simplified. So the resultant force, the resultant pressure on this point is equal to 3,000 kilogram per meter square. We are using, if I'm using tons, so I will say 3 tons per 1 meter square. So each 1 meter square of this body and the bottom of this body will can hold only 3 tons. Now, these are called the fluid properties when they are in the rest, or it's called static load. The same that we have, sometimes you have merged, submerged, and merged planes. Sometimes you have curved space. So sometimes if there is, let me say, if there is a boot like this, there's a boot, and this boot is having a curvature here. So this curve can be pushed out by the pressure of the water. And this is called, this is a curvature or curved plane that is there. Okay, we have in fluid dynamics, we have two types or many types of flow. There is a steady flow, there is unsteady flow. What does that mean? If you have a channel of channel that's letting to a queue, so a steady flow, it means that I said, when I say the queue, the discharge of water through this channel one, it's equal to 1 meter cube per, let's say, per second. So at any point in this channel, if I measured the flow, and at any, by the way, we have something called flow meter. If I use the flow meter at any point, then I will get 1 meter cube, then it's called steady state. Steady state, it means that at any point, there is no difference. Here, there, downstream, upstream, anywhere, there is the same flow of water. Sometimes we have unsteady. It means that in a point, and usually it will be when we have a cross-section change. There is, let me say, here's cross-section of the channel is not like here. So at point one and at point two, so the flow here is not equal to the flow at point two. So that's called non-steady state. So steady state is the flow at point, if the Q at point A, if the point Q at point A was equal to Q at point 2, that's called the steady state. If there was a difference, that there was a difference in the flow at these sections, then it's called non-steady state. This is in terms of uniformity. This is called in terms of steady flow. And by the way, we are coming to these, all of these in details from the, for the, so this is just an introduction. We have laminar and turbulent flow. What does that mean? Laminar, it means the liquid is going layer over layer. It means it's going slowly. So slowly, it means that we have a small velocity through of the liquid through a pipe. While turbulent, it means that we have a disturbed flow. We have anywhere flow. So let me show it to you. If I take a pipe, this is, was a pipe, and the flow is going this way. So when I put an ink, when I put a drop of ink here in this injected, if I inject the pipe with ink, so I will see the direction or the stream that's caused by this ink will be laminar, will be like a line, like a thin line. This is called, that's because we have a slow motion of the liquid. This is called laminar flow. So laminar, it means we have a slow motion. And later on, you know how to distinguish between them, how to know which one is laminar, which one is not laminar, or it's in turbulent, or it's in between. This is in term of Reynolds number. We have a Reynolds number, which is later on, you will know how to find them. We have, as I said, we have a turbulent flow. And turbulent, it just means that we have a hurry. We have, it means that the ink, you will not see, if you put a drop ink here, you will not see a streamline. You will see a disturbance for the mixing. It will be mixed directly. Then it means that you have a very disturbed motion of the flow in this pipe. And so on, we have many, and by the way, we see that this is streamlined. We have many points that it will be under the kinematic. These are called kinematic properties of the liquids. While we have hydrodynamic, it's the hydro power, how much it can be, the power that's coming due to the motion of the, we say we have types of the motion. Then after that, we have to know how much is the power that can be taken from this motion, and it's called hydrodynamics. And also we have different points. When the flow of water or the flow of liquids like a human, when he's now here, and when he wants to go another where, then he have to, the water should lose energy. So that's called energy losses or head losses. So we have head losses. There are many equations that measure that equation. One of them is called Bernoulli equation. So Bernoulli is one of the scientists that studying how much it will be the loss or how much it needs to move a 1 meter cube of water from a point to another point. So it will depend on many things. One of them is the velocity. One of them is the liquid is in a level and the next station of that liquid is down or up also. So if it's up, we need to have to put a pump up, and then you have to calculate how much is the head of that pump it should be. As I mentioned that we have flow measurement, that we have dimensional analysis. These, the dimensional analysis, as I said, there have to be units of L for length, By the way, we have M. M is for mass. When I say gamma, or let me say rho, sorry, rho, it means the specific, when I say rho, rho, it means the specific weight, it's equal to mass over volume. So mass can be a mass, or how many kilograms per meter cube that we have in water, we have 1,000. So in dimensional analysis, they say rho is equal to mass, M, divided by L cube. So this is another representation for the definitions in terms of dimensional analysis. Also, why we are studying the fluids? Because we need to protect, we need to build a dam. For that one, we have to be very accurate in calculating the loads. We have to know how much is the load that can be exerted through transferring fluids like water, oil, gas, through a main pipeline, that, like what we have. How much it should be, how much we need, how much is the density, how much is the pipe diameter we need. Also, we need oceanography that needs, how much is the power that will be, the pressure on this boot. Sometimes we need to know how much is the city water and air pollution. Okay, we need to know, this is a swelling, soil swelling, or when we have a water table, the water table is the level of the groundwater. If it's in a very high water table, if you have high water table, it means that you are just excavating for meters and you will find water. So it means that there is a high water table. High water table, it means that you have a water pressure. Water pressure, that means we have a load that's going up. So that will act and make a crack for your buildings and not safety. We need to know to have fluids for any structures in the rivers and in the, like this palm. This is the palm island and so on. As I said, we have these definitions. Okay, so we say the state of materials or matters, we have three states of matters. We have liquids, we have gas, we have solids. So in this chapter, in this course, we are just dealing with fluids. There are many differences between the fluids and the gas and the fluids and the solids. And I think, you know, and it's for easy for you to know how is the difference. The main points are written here in green and blue. That we have in liquids, free surface. While for gases, there's no free surface. We are accurately, the gases are, they are not in a limited, or they are, they have, they don't have, they have definite volumes. So gases can be condensed and released at any pressure, but this is not true for the liquids. And I know that's easy for you because this is for the secondary or primary schools, secondary schools. The main units that we are using in this course are the centimeter gram second units, and so centimeter gram second, that's the French units. There are many books are dealing with the system international and meter, kilogram, and second. Some of them are British gravitational system, feet, leg, and seconds. So you have to be aware. Here's the symbols that we are using them in our course. L for, by the way, the same will be used for the dimensional analysis. Mass as M, time as T. This is T capital, by the way. We have small t, we have T capital. We have theta, we have I, which is the current. and we have amount of light, we have amount of matters that we have, and so on. Here's the units. We are using length, time, force, velocity. It's equal to length divided by t, and acceleration is the length of t divided by t. How much is the variation of the velocity from a point to another point? So it's the delta v, it's by delta t, which is called the acceleration, and it's equal to meter per second square, and so on. We have energy for 1 meter, this is called joule, and we have other systems that we have, and we have power. The power is equal to energy per one per unit time, and so on. Okay, so there are many conversion factors that we have to be aware from this one. And I think you are not find any difficulty or any struggling with these units because they are open. This is open. By the way, we are in this course, it's an open formula for you, but you have to be aware in the unit con version that maybe we have in this chapter. Here is some MCQs that I want you to go through with, and it's easy, and just to be familiar with the kind of MCQs if we have it in our exam. Okay. I hope it was interesting to you, this lecture. If you have any question or you want to add something, I forget to add it, I'm ready to listen to you. Hello?
Sir, I have a question.
Yes.
Should we memorize definitions?
And nothing will be, I'm not asking you to memorize anything. So by the way, the questions in fluid mechanics will be all numerous. But I want you to understand all the terms that, because they are all dealing with each other, and it's very important to know how to, so it's required to understand, not to memorize.
Thank you.
Okay. Was it interesting to you, this lecture? By the way, I will send you a recorded one for you and put it in the classroom. Okay. So if you don't have any questions, so you can leave. And I will send you a list of attendance to your emails, to your classroom.
Doctor, I have a question, please.
Yes.
Did you take the attendance, please, doctor?
That's what I talked about. This is, I say that we are not taking the attendance. It's automatically will be taken by using the Zoom meeting itself.
So, doctor, is that okay if we sometimes left the group and again entering the room?
Yes, the attendance will be like this. For example, you can, when you are here, you are, they say that Mr. X will attend the meeting at this time and left at this time and get back to the meeting at this time, and he spent with us, he was with us for 29-30 how much minutes it was. So I'm not going to.
Thank you so much. It's okay. It's okay, doctor. Thank you so much.
I want you to be, not to be absent, because not this, from the next lectures, there will be a series and there will be calculations, examples, and you have to be attentive. You have to pay attention to the every single examples that we are going to solve it in the classroom. And so,
okay, doctor, thank you so much.
Thank you so much, doctor.
Hello, welcome. So, until that time, you can leave. And thank you very much for being with me.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, doctor.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, doctor.
Bye bye.
Thank you, doctor.
Bye bye. Welcome.
Doctor,
sorry. Yes.
Mr. Akko?
Yes. Yes, Halkot.
Mr. Akko, I have a question about those who are living outside of Sulaimani, about the lab.
Yes.
What should we do? I'm trying to find a lab in Erbil to do the same experiment that you are doing in Sulaimania. But
yes. I think they will not let you to do it because also the same rules are here, the same and there. But I want you manage that thing with your friends. So if you are in a group with your friends, let me say for three, you and three of your colleagues in one group, then if they are living in Sulaimania, so it will be better because they will come and they will, make an open live session in the while we are taking the experiment. And you can be with us within the time of the experiment, which is not taking more than 1 hour. So you can manage it with your friends. And if you also find difficulties or if you are struggling with this one, just know I will solve it for you in another way.
Okay, thank you very much. Thank you very much.
Doctor, I have a question.
Yes.
For the lab, when we have a lab class?
I will announce it for you it will be from the next lab, from the next week, okay?
It's at that time scheduled in our...
I will schedule everything based on that, on the lab. Based on the members in the groups and their their schedule. So I will just post or share with you an Excel sheet to know how you are dealing or how you are selecting your partners. Then after that, I will manage it by myself. So don't worry, I will manage it in a very good way.
Okay, thank you so much, Doctor.
You're welcome.
Have a good day.
Sir.
Yes,
Farad. Good evening.
Good evening, Farad.
How are you doing?
I'm fine.
Sir, actually, today I was registering for your two classes, the water classes. I told you before, like, these two classes are gonna only available in fall, and I wanna graduate in spring. And I don't know what did you do in the last lectures for these two classes, because I missed today the registration at my name to your class.
Okay, so for the previous two classes, I recorded them and I posted them. Actually, for the first one, it was only for an introduction about the course and the syllabus and the course syllabus and the grade distribution. The second one and this one, it's recording and I will post them, and some of them I posted in the class and shared with the students, and you can find it in the YouTube. And so just go through the classroom and you will find the stream, the YouTube link and you in the materials.
All right. But actually, I was dropping this classes. So could you please remove my names in that classes? Because they forced me to take two classes, I have to drop one of them. Because for all the times offer in every semester, in regular semester, but the two other classes is not like that.
Okay, so now you dropped water resources and water supply.
Yeah, it's with you. But they said that you have to drop flute.
Again, drop flutes also?
No, I drop flute, but I take the two classes with you. Okay. You know, I told you my situation before.
Yes, I know that. So now you are taking water supply and water resources.
Yeah, exactly.
And you are here with the flutes now.
But yeah, I dropped actually. That's why I said remove my names here.
Okay, thank you. I will do it. Okay.
Just all right. Thank you so much.
Remind me. Okay.
Sure. Thank you so much. Have a good day.
Sir?
Yes, dear.
Can you hear me?
Yes, dear.
Is there,
you move to this one?
I'm sorry, just could you repeat that one?
The lecture.
The what? I can't hear you.
I mean the mic systems. Are we going to this side? So I'm just going to write it for you so you can read it, okay?
Dear, could you write it as an email to me? Because I can't okay. hear you, okay? Yes. Okay, guys, so waiting for you. Yes.
Sorry for the late question, but the group that we will be making for the lab, it should be how many people?
Then you should not be more than three.
Three, so, right?
Yeah, three. You have to be with your partners, no more than three. Okay.
Okay.
I will share it with you, and I will just write your name on your partner's name in that group. Okay. Okay, Nishtman. So. Okay. So we see you later with the next session, inshallah. So have a nice day, and keep strong and keep safe. Bye bye.
Bye, sir.
Bye-bye.